Sometimes you're going to want to create a display that's got very tiny trends on it. You want to expand those trends easily so people can see them. So for example, here's a trend. It's kind of big and it's covering up a lot of things. I think what I'd like to do, I still want this trend here, but I'm going to reduce it down. I use the little bounding bars in build mode. So I'm in build mode here. Every once in a while you see in an operating environment, you're much more interested in density of detail than in making it look very pretty. So sometimes you see these little tiny trends. And so how do you make use of these? What's the good of these if they're so tiny? Well, in run mode, if you double click on these trends, you'll notice they expand to fill the window. Now, here's probably the single most common mistake I see people make in our training. At this point, oh gosh, hundreds of hours of conditioning with web browsers and all kinds of user interfaces would tend to make you think the way to get out of this is by either pressing escape or by just closing this X right here, which actually will close the display. But in fact, if you just double click again, that's going to return this to the normal size. So it's not real intuitive. You double click to expand, double click again to get this back to its normal size. So when you're expanding these, that's the key. What you'll see every once in a while, as a manager, you may see this as people are using your displays. You double click to expand, and then they naturally kind of hit this X button here to close it. But in fact, what they're going to do is close the whole display when all they really want to do is return to the normal size window. So that's how you would expand and contract this window. Now remember, that's only going to work in run mode. In build mode, if I were to double click on this, it's going to go into the builder screen for that trend. So make sure you're in run mode when you do this. And again, double clicking will return this to the normal size.